Angelina Jolie used a New York Times op-ed to deliver the news. She has undergone a double mastectomy as a preventive measure because she has a very high likelihood of developing breast cancer. The actress's announcement prompted CNN anchor Zoraida Samblin to share her own news with the viewers.
I thank Angelina Jolie for making it easier. I was trying to figure out, Carol, how do I tell the viewers I'm going to be gone for a while? How do I tell them about my breast cancer? How do I talk about a double mastectomy?
The subject has special resonance for Michelle Cottle, correspondent for Newsweek and The Daily Beast, who recently wrote about her own battle with breast cancer. Michelle Cottle, welcome.
Thanks.
Angelina Jolie seems to have gotten a little more attention than you for going public with the news of her double mastectomy. People are saying it was brave of her, being an international celebrity movie star, to come forward in this fashion. Do you agree?
You know, I actually do agree. On some level, people always say that. They're being nice. Oh, it's so brave of you. You know, how, you know, I'm so impressed. But with a woman like Angelina Jolie, she's not even a regular movie star. She's a movie star whose appeal has stemmed in large part from the fact that she's every man's fantasy. You know, it's a kind of sensual beauty that if you kind of mess with that fantasy, you never know how people are going to react. So while, you know, practically speaking, realistically, there shouldn't be any difference to kind of the news, you know, her announcement, on some level, you just never know. And so I think it actually was a huge deal for her to go public with something that she really just didn't have to.
You recently underwent this surgery, and as you write, you weren't surprised to find yourself on the operating table. Why?
Well, you know, I'd had structural issues and family history issues for years. And so when I found out that I had a bad biopsy back a few months ago, the diagnosis I had was usually treated with kind of, they have breast-conserving lumpectomies and radiations and things like this. But for me, it was kind of a no-brainer. I'd had trouble. I knew that if I just kind of went the half measure, I was going to have trouble again. And so I was just like, that's it. It's a one strike and you're out policy. So
you wanted to put this behind you.
Exactly.
But the whole thing and the decision-making process and the surgery, it feels very private. Why did you decide to sit down and write about it in such detail?
Well, for one thing, when you tell people what you're doing, a lot of people just respond with gasps, or they seem very upset, or they seem very sad for you. And for me, this was not something to be really upset about. I mean, obviously, the initial diagnosis was. But as far as kind of my decision to go with a bilateral mastectomy, I had no problem with it. And so by writing about it, you kind of have the opportunity to control the narrative, to say, hey, you don't need to be this upset about this. And for me, it wasn't a difficult decision at all. And so I'm hoping that, you know, other women look at these choices and don't necessarily kind of fear this sort of thing.
Was it hard to write?
It actually wasn't all that hard to write. I mean, when you've had the health problems for years and years, you've sat down and you've thought these through. And, you know, I'd actually a couple of years ago thought about going the route that Angelina Jolie did and kind of do a prophylactic.
To preemptively doctors, have the surgery.
Doctors don't like to do that a lot of the time unless you have the genes like she does, and I'd tested negative for that. So I kind of wound up waiting one step later than I should have. But still, it was a no-brainer.
But it was important to you that people not feel sorry for you, that you know, you were very comfortable with this decision. In fact, as you write, because of your family history and the nature of your breasts, you were almost expecting this for years. It was something that was hanging over your head.
And women tend, not all women, and I think younger women less so these days, tend to get very kind of touchy about their breasts. You know, they worry about body image, and I had doctors and friends and relatives ask me, well, are you concerned about body image issues? And I'm like, absolutely not. I mean, we're talking about a fundamental health issue here. You know, plus I got a great reconstructive surgeon, so it wasn't as big a deal as it used to be, I think. I think younger, I mean, my doctor said that younger women in particular often just don't want to waste a lot of time going through all these stages.
So were you writing for people who know you, or were you writing for as a kind of an example to help educate women who you will never meet about confronting one way, we should say, of dealing with breast cancer, or in Angelina Jolie's case, the threat of breast cancer?
I mean, I just think anything that takes women from being self-conscious about this, I think you need to have people talk about it. And certainly, you know, I wrote about it, but that has no comparison to what happens when Angelina Jolie, you know, the sexiest woman in the world, stands up and says, hey, I did this. It was a choice that I needed to do for my family, and I'm good with it.
No, I'm using both of you in the same sentence.
Yeah, it's a mistake people often make.
But on this question of body image, which is a sensitive one, and particularly in a society where women tend to be judged by their looks, women who are either in the movie industry or appear on camera, on television, as you often do, and you wrote this, everybody loves boobs. But no matter how fetching mine looked in sweaters or swimsuits or La Perla bustiers, especially before time, gravity, and two pregnancies took their toll, I could never shake the sense that they were plotting against me. I cleaned that up a little
bit. Yeah, you cleaned up the language there. That was kind of you. And it's true. I mean, people get really wrapped up in body image. And, you know, if you go to a plastic surgeon's office, the vast majority of women coming through there are getting just regular old boob jobs. You know, they want them bigger. They want to look more like what they see in the movies or whatever. But then you have to kind of make this decision about, you know, what's it worth. And I think that when they confront these medical realities, they just have to make these kinds of decisions. And it shouldn't be that hard for
them. In the end, medical reality, health, your future, worrying about being there for your kids counts more than.
And it matters less for me, because that's not what I do for my job, than it does for someone like Angelina Jolie. But she said it too. You know, she's like, I said it for my kids. I want to be there for them. And I think that sort of thing trumps almost everything else.
Well, I think thanks to you and your piece and Angelina Jolie, a lot of people are going to look at this in a different way. Michelle Cottle.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks very much for sitting down with us.